See next problem. Okay, the second one. Okay, reciprocating pump weights 677 newton. Okay, so 665, 667 newton. Okay, it is mounted on a middle of steel plate of thickness 0.012 meter. Okay, the width of that plate is 0.508 okay meter. The length is 2.55 meter. Okay, so it is clamped at the two edges, okay, like a simply supported beam. Okay, so the pump is placed on a plate, okay, that is fixed at two ends. Okay, during operation, the force, okay, exerted by the pump is given by FD. Okay, the force is exerted by the pump onto the plate is given by 222.4 cos 62.832 newton. okay, so this is the function, means it is varying with the time. Okay, that variation is expressed using a cos function. Okay, so you may assume that the initial position and initial velocity always will be zero, that is as per our assumption. Okay, so that is not assumption, it is exactly like initial position will be always zero and initial velocity will be always zero. Since the position is zero, that is displacement is zero, then the velocity observed, it will be zero, because displacement differentiation is velocity. Okay, so the Young's modulus of the material which the plate is made up of is given by 207 GPa. okay, so this is the data is given. So not what they are asking is determine the general solution, okay, that expects the vibrational motion of the plate on which pump is mounted. Okay, so the image is like this. It's not coming, wait, it will come. Okay, so it came. Now see here, so let me take pointer, laser pointer. Okay, so this is the pump. Okay, so it is placed on a plate, okay, which is of 0.0217 thickness, okay, 2.55 meter. Okay, then width is 0.508 meter. Okay, so now we have to find its response, okay, due to its operation. Okay, when it is operating, force exerted by is this function. Okay, so in this manner the force is exerted onto the plate. Okay, and that's what they are given, and you have to find out what is the response, okay, using general solution. Okay, from the general solution, state the amplitude of the vibration of the plate. Okay, so amplitude of this plate you have to determine. Okay, you have to explain it. Okay, that is second question. Third question is, a design requirement of the plate on which pump is mounted is that the amplitude of vibration be less than the 7 mm. Based on your analysis, state whether the design requirement is satisfied or not. Okay, so someone has asked you to design this plate, okay, based on the operation of this one, and they are given requirement as the displacement of this plate should be below 7 mm. Okay, so you should design in such a way that the displacement obtained in the plate due to operation of pump should be below 7 mm. Okay, that's what it means. Okay, now we have to verify according to this dimension and the forcing function whether you are getting more than 7 mm or less than 7 mm. If it is less than 7 mm, your design is safe. Okay, if it is more than 7 mm, the design is not safe. Okay, based on that we can change our dimension so that it will become below 7 mm. Okay, so that is the last question. Okay, now we'll see what is the given in the question. We'll write down. Okay, the plate can be modeled as a fixed beam having Young's modulus. Why fixed? Here it is clamped, here it is clamped, means all degrees of freedoms are fixed at restricted at this location and at this location, so it will become a simply supported beam. Okay, the force is acting at the middle. Okay, now Young's modulus is given 207 GPa, width is given, weight is given 667 newton, that is weight of the pump. Okay, the thickness is given 0.0127. okay, breadth is given 0.508 meter, length is given 2 0.55 meter. Okay, forcing function is 222.4 cos 62.8832 t. Okay, times. Okay, as the time varies, the forcing function is changes. Okay, this is the magnitude and this is the frequency omega. Omega is 62.832. Remember, it is not omega n. Okay, omega n is natural frequency that you have to find out. Okay, but here it is given omega. Okay, now you see what you have to find out. We have mass. Okay, so we need mass. Okay, but they are given weight. Okay, how to convert it into weight into mass? Divided by 9.81. okay, 667 divided by 9.81 will give 68 kg. okay, so this is the mass. Next, we need stiffness. So if you need stiffness, since it is a simply supported beam, how to find out stiffness? There is a formula. Okay, so this is from strength of material. Okay, you should remember that simply supported beam stiffness K is 192 EI by L cube. Okay, how it came is deflection of beam. Go to deflection of beam in strength of material. Go to simply supported beam with center point. Okay, center point loading or point loading. So they will get the deflection. From deflection, you get this formula. Okay, that's where it came. Okay, so you have to remember that. If you not understood, go to strength of material, deflection of beam, and find out how it came. Okay, what we need is E we need, I we need, and L we need. Okay, E is already given. Okay, I is not given. How to find out? Since it is a rectangle, the moment of inertia, I is given by BDQ divided by 12. Okay, B is 0.508 and D is 0.0127. okay, so 127 is cube times. Okay, now you take the value and you can substitute in this equation, K equation. Okay, now 192, Young's modulus is 207 into 10 raised to 9 GPa into Pa Pascal. Then I, so I is straight away I kept here. Okay, the length is 2.55 cube. okay, now if I solve this equation, so I will get 207847.43 newton per meter. Okay, now you solve, take a pen and paper or take calculator and solve this. Okay, put it into one equation. So if you enter this in a function in a calculator, so you will directly get the K value. Okay, now we check. Okay, you should use calculator, so you will get first answers. Okay, now see, the answer is 207847.43 newton meter. That is the stiffness of the plate. Okay, so you should get this 207847.43 newton per meter. Okay, that is the stiffness of this plate. Okay, mass we got, mass of this. Okay, it is like spring and mass system. Okay, so this is the mass, this is the spring. Okay, the forcing function is getting from the excitation. Okay, that is forcing function. Okay, so this is a spring mass system with the forced vibration. Okay, so that is how you have to understand this problem. Okay, next, mass we got, stiffness we got. Okay, now we need general solution. Okay, general solution is response of the system. So response of the system is xt. Xt is equal to f naught divided by k minus m omega square cos omega t minus cos omega nt. Okay, how we got? As we got in the previous problem. Okay, so you check with the previous problem, problem number one. So how you got this? Okay, there is a harmonic solution plus particular solution. Okay, in harmonic solution and particular solution, if you put x naught and x naught dot is equal to 0, you will get this equation. Okay, since I already explained in the previous problem, so I am not going to explain here. Okay, so you have to take it from the previous problem. Okay, but you have to follow the same step. Okay, so if you substitute initial condition into the original general solution, so you will get this equation. Okay, the original general solution which is given in the previous problem, and if you substitute in that, so you will get this equation. Okay, now here we need this one. Okay, this term is called displacement or amplitude of the vibration, f naught divided by k minus m omega square. So this is x. Okay, this is amplitude of the vibration. This is what you have to find out. Okay, next we need omega. Omega is already given in the forcing function, where here. Okay, 62.832. okay, that omega is given, but we need omega n. Okay, so first we need this one and we need omega n. Okay, so you have to find out this. Okay, next, first one, amplitude of oscillation, that is x. Okay, this term, f naught divided by k minus m omega square. Okay, so we'll see what is f naught. F naught is the magnitude of the forcing function. Magnitude of the forcing function is 222.4. This is f naught cos omega t. Okay, you remember this, f naught cos omega t. So f naught value is 222.4. okay, put 222.4 here. Okay, so we need, okay, you see the general equation, right? It will come. General equation is xt, this term cos omega t, this term sin omega t, and this term. If you put x naught 0, x naught dot 0, x 0, so this will eliminate. So we will get this function. Okay, next. So we need x. Okay, so x value is, f naught value is 222.4. k value we got already from the previous, that is stiffness of the plate. Okay, see, the mass is 68. Okay, the omega is 62.832. how 68 came? 667 divided by 9.81. okay, weight is converted into mass. Okay, 68 kg, mass is 68 kg. 62.83 is forcing frequency. Okay, so if we substitute and solve for x, so you'll get minus 0.003669 meter. Okay, so this is the amplitude of oscillation. Okay, so this answers our first. Okay, not answer for first, this is amplitude of frequency. Okay, if we substitute in the equation omega and omega n. Okay, omega n we need. What is the equation for omega n? Root k by m. K is 20784 7.43 Newton per meter divided by mass. Okay, mass is 68. Okay, if we solve it, we will get 55.286 rad per second. Okay, see, this is the omega n. Okay, we need response. Okay, so response of the general solution of the system. Okay, so xt, now you substitute into xt. Okay, substitute in the system response equation, you will get this. Okay, this value is 0.003669 m. okay, cos 52.828260. okay, minus 0.00369 cos 62.832. okay, this one we send it to this side, this one we send it to this side. Okay, that's why it came. Why? Because this term is negative. Okay, negative into negative, positive. Okay, so it will come here. Okay, since it is positive, this term will come this side. Okay, and they will swap because of negative. Okay, negative of this value. Okay, so this is your system response. Okay, now the first question is, what is the amplitude of the vibration? The amplitude of vibration is 0.003669 meter, which is 3.69 mm. okay, the first question is, find the general solution. Okay, so this is the general solution. Second question is, what is the frequency amplitude of the vibration? The amplitude of vibration is 3.669 meter. okay, so the next one is, we have to verify whether the design is safe or not. Okay, what is the condition is given? The permissible vibration amplitude is less than the 7 mm. okay, so if it is less than 7 mm, the vibrations are acceptable. Okay, so let's check. So here it is given 7 mm, and what we got is 3.669. okay, so it is way below the 7 mm. Hence the conclusion is, our design is acceptable. Okay, the vibrations are acceptable. Okay, so the design is safe. Okay, that's what it means. Okay. Okay, so this is the second problem. Okay, so if you answer these things, so you'll get full marks. Okay, so this is the overall picture of spring mass system and how to solve the problem. Okay, in the application point of view. Okay, these are all thought-provoking questions. Okay, so who they are thought-provoking questions? Because they are leveling into the application level. Okay, so if you have any doubts, you can ping me here. Okay, yeah, bye.